God, there's a lot of honey in that coffee. Right. This video is by my friend's girlfriend's dad. So these guys are from Scotland. This is Zoe's dad, my friend's Kyle Motherwell. And this is called Must See Places in Scotland, and he's got West Lothian in the thing. So this will be interesting for us.
Today I'm going to tell you about industrial history, great inventors, political intrigue, assassination, and show you the most fantastic prehistoric monument that's been standing for more than 5,000 years. How many times has somebody said to you, "I fancy a fantastic historical day out in Scotland. Let's go to Bathgate."
I used to live in Bathgate, so did Kyle. Zoe used to visit quite often. That's Zoe Fumey. This is Fumey. This is Bruce Fumey. That's her dad. So we know Bathgate. People know Bathgate. This is definitely West Lothian.
That's right, never! But today, I'm going to show you why that's wrong. If you're interested in the people, places and events in Scottish history, then click the subscribe button at the bottom right of the screen. In the meantime, let me tell you a story.
Just like the video.
If you've seen this channel, then you'll know that I always like to tell you a story. And I suppose today's story is one of misunderstanding. Not like when a sitcom character desperately rushes around meddling in things that he shouldn't because he misconstrues romantic interest. Or he has to extricate himself from an embarrassing situation he's created by solving somebody else's problem that never existed in the first place. No. This is misunderstanding that stems as much from our apathy as our assumptions. You see, today, I'm going to show you that somewhere you'd never thought of as a place to visit is in fact a must-see, whether you live in Scotland or you're just visiting. I've started the Benny Museum in Bathgate, and we're going to end up at possibly the most fantastic prehistoric monument in the Scottish mainland. But you'll be surprised at how much there is to see along the way. We're going to travel about 6 miles in total. Now, all but a tiny bit is drivable, mainly on B roads. If you're energetic, you could even...
B roads stands for back roads. It's not like A and B, it's like these are back roads. I like he's taking his bike, that's sick.
Walk it. I am going to take my bike. I've made another video on the industrial heritage West Lothian and how it kickstarted Scotland's oil boom. There'll be links to that one at the end. But as we go on this journey through time, you'll see that this place has so much more to offer.
I've been up here, I climbed up this side, and you walk to the other side. Yeah, I've definitely been up here. My stepdad, who is no longer with us, he went down one of these when he was a teenager in a giant tractor wheel. You know, the inner wheel? He climbed inside it. Apologies. And rolled down the side of this one of these out into the field. He said it crossed the first field without stopping and it crashed through a fence.
If you've ever...
And he lived in Polbeth, which is right next door to the Five Sisters.
Ever been a hospital for an operation? As you went under and consciousness melted away, it probably never occurred to you that the guy who first made it possible for you to be unconscious while they cut was a Bathgate lad called James Young Simpson. Cool. If you haven't already, you should watch my video about him.
There's a school here in West Lothian called James Young High School, so now I know where that comes from.
When you've been on a luxury cruise ship, or the Ardrossan to Broderick Ferry, did it ever occur to you, as you munched your canapes at the captain's table, that leaving Bathgate through the village of Turfichen, you'd be passing through the birthplace of Henry Bell, the man who invented steamships? I bet you didn't.
Steamed chips.
You were probably too busy smiling at the name Turfichen. Turfichen.
Turfichen.
Turfichen.
Turfichen Inn.
But there's even more interesting stuff in Turfichen than the name suggests. Because 7 centuries before steamships, Turfichen Preceptory was a Scottish home of the Crusader Knights Hospitaller. Now, this is a place worth a visit. It was originally funded by David the First, but then again, wasn't everything. People make much of the Scottish connection to the Knights Templar. Of course, the other famous order of knights at the time were the Knights Hospitaller.
I have no idea of that.
Their more formal title was actually the Order of the Hospital of St John of Jerusalem, hence the St John's Ambulance today. And no doubt...
Jack, could you get that please?
West Lothian St John's Hospital, not far from here. The Korean War is known as the Forgotten War. But it's not forgotten in these hills above Bathgate. The Scottish-Korean War Memorial is a place of contemplation, solitude, and a memorial to the 1114 named men who died a long way from these shores. If I continue round the hill, then it takes me to Persephone's Temple, a stone circle just beneath the knob.
There's a crossroad bridge in the background.
It's at the top of the Bathgate Hills. Now, I'm prepared to bet that most folk in Scotland don't think of places like this when they think of Bathgate. I'll be honest, it's not as old as you think.
I think of places like the Green Tree Pub, Raz's Superstore, the corner shop, my mum's old community spirit shop that was in Bathgate on the precinct. I remember the old tobacco and confectionery. I remember Chalmers. There's a Pizza Hut. There's a Greg's. There's loads. There's the Purple Orange for music. YOLO was there. It had the mini grand piano in the window. Bathgate's amazing.
But it does show that if you scratch the surface of the scabs of preconception, you'll find something surprising. And probably quite itchy.
What?
But just a few more feet till we're at the top and there's more. They call this the Knock. From here, you can see West Lothian and beyond. You can see from the Forth Bridges that way, all the way across to the Isle of Arran in the other direction. If you look towards Linlithgow, you can see the place where the first time in the world ever a head of state was shot.
I lived
because we invented Ohing. Actually, I made a video about that. You can see where Mary, Queen of Scots, was born.
I've lived here. There's a place called Bridge End. This is where I am right now, in this corner. Bathgate's over here. I've also lived in Blackridge. I've lived in Blackburn. I've been up here. There's Polbeth. The Five Sisters are up around here.
I'm going to jump to the shop. Do you want anything?
You get me a can of juice?
Yeah, can do.
Just anything? Thank you. My brother's nice. He's getting me a can of juice. He's going to the shop.
You can see the first village in the UK to get street lighting, where one of the pioneering workers' cooperatives was established. You can visit Outlander film locations, stately homes, a medieval castle, a worked-out silver mine, the location of the world's first commercial oil refinery, take an historic canal boat trip towards the Falkirk Wheel. Are you getting me here? Tell me in the comment section if you have or if you'd like to visit any of these places.
I would like
that. Way, I'll know if I'm on the right track with what I'm telling you.
Take me, Bruce.
But
take
the place in West Lothian that I really want to show you has been there long before all of these. Let me take...
Real ask here, like, could... Bruce, would you be up for taking some of Zoe's boyfriend's friends on a small trip for a video, maybe? We could have fun with that. Oh, we're quite nice people. We really are. We're very, very easy going.
Take you to Cairnpapel.
Oh, me and a friend wrote a song in the past. It goes like this: Cairnpapel, shitey apple, iron brew, Dana poo, bucky and fish. I can't remember. It was a lot of Scottish things, and at the end it goes, "I fucking love Scotland." I was also in the house. They split my primary school up into houses like Harry Potter. I was in the Cairnpapel house. There you go. So I learned about Cairnpapel in primary school.
Now I know Cairnpapel sounds like a Scottish tropical fruit, but it's actually... Well, let me show you. This place is truly astonishing. This hill has been a place of significance for more than 5,000 years. From the earliest times, people...
5,000 years. What are all these holes? I wondered what these are. I've actually never visited Cairn Papa. I would love to go. But where are the holes? These are like pit holes. It's strange the way they're laid out as well.
People have been coming up this hill. 2,000 years before the Romans arrived, people had been coming here for more than 1,000 years. Now, Rome wasn't built in a day, and this didn't all happen overnight either. In the late Neolithic, like once folk had got to grips with farming and that, they dug these 7 holes. Archaeologists have found human cremation remains inside them. And then, at some point, they reckon that the 3 central sockets had megalithic stone monuments towering out of them. Later still, they raised 24 standing stones in an oval henge roundabout and dug a ditch around that. You know what folks say? If you're a time machine and you could go back to any time period, when would it be? Right now. I'd want it to be the time when folk were deciding to extend the construction work here. I'd love to have been in the planning meeting to see who was proposing the extension and why. Who objected and what was their reasoning? Yeah. Who overruled them? Was there a vote? Did it come to blows? Did they remember by this stage who were cremated in the 7 holes or why that happened? Was it privately funded or did it come out of council tax? Belief systems were changing. And much later, they were digging rectangular graves within the line of the 24 henge stones and they were leaving grave goods. But by 2000 BC, they'd stopped using the henge for religious purposes. Now let me repeat that. 2000 years before Jesus came along was when they stopped using the henge here.
2000 BC.
I often wonder, did the change in ceremonial practices come with violent confrontation like the Reformation? Were they imposed? How far did people come from? We know that tools had got here from North Wales thousands of years before.
That's amazing.
By the Bronze Age, somebody decided to build burial kists inside this stone circle. Later, they were covered in a cairn of loose stones so that the 24 standing stones could be better used as kerb stones to hold those smaller stones in. Later still, an even bigger cairn was built that you can see is the outer circle today. The inner circle cairn of stones has been removed and covered over by a dome which is higher than the original cairn would have been. But it allows us to go inside and see what would have been under that cairn.
What do you think's under here? What do you think's under here? Oh man, it could be anything. I play the game RuneScape, so I think one of the Barrows brothers is under here. Probably Dyrex, he's the first one you face, but game shit aside, this is probably just going to be some sort of tomb. It's like a dark hole filled with stone. I don't know what to expect.
Oh,
damn, we can already tell it's not. That's not what I thought, but I was going to say they probably keep the grass cutters in here, like the lawnmowers for cutting the grass.
This would have been submerged under the stones of the cairn, and from Bronze Age times, so would these. Graves that once contained grave goods, foods to take to the afterlife, provided by those who must inevitably follow at some point later. I can never bring this place alive in the way that Dylan, the local steward, can. You must come down here and speak to him yourself. But who was it that was so important to have been given the privilege of this prestige location? Royalty? A religious figure? A politician, pop star, civil servant, entrepreneur. Maybe all these things wrapped into one. They would have seen the world in quite a different way to us. And that's the thing. Whenever I find myself in these places, I always wonder what went through their minds, don't you? They say that the past is another country. The people buried here certainly wouldn't have understood my language or I theirs. I think that's what we find intriguing. We all want to know how they ticked and what they felt, what they thought. We're curious to understand these people from that country of a different time. And that makes me wonder, if we make so much effort to understand people from a different time, Why can't we take the time to understand the people in our own time today? Either way, there's loads for you to see and do in West Lothian. Check out the website, I'll leave a link in the description. And I've got another video to show you more coming up on screen now. In the meantime, Hamia Doch is going to be Lama Ali.
Should we watch this one for the channel? The Scotsman who played Satan at Cards. I think that would be a good watch at some point. I love Bruce. See his, the way he talks. The audio in his videos are awesome. Like, it's this very soft way of talking to you. And I'm going to tell you how things are. And what happened. And I'm going to make you think about stuff. Probably bring everything we know about the past into the present just for a moment. I like that way of communicating. It's kind of cool. What they don't say about the kilt. Yeah. Okay, right. Thanks for the these videos. You're not doing them for me, Bruce, but hopefully you're okay with me covering this, reacting to it. I'm just kind of clicking on things on my feed. Here's my brother. Come this way. Come here. Come close. Come close. Get on the camera for a second. There you go. I don't know if you can see him. Cool. Bye.
Bye.
Oh, this is a good gist to...
Yeah.
Right. Bye.